Hi, this is Dr. Saxena, and I welcome you to our show, and where we are talking on something like some topics which concerns all of us. When I talk about this, I just want to start with one particular thing. Is the sun avoidance is a major cause of mortality. This is one of the study which was presented in 2017 that found that the woman with active sun exposure have lower mortality than those who avoid it. I must tell you one thing, we are not avoiding this purposefully, but somewhere we got into that habit of avoiding that sun and sunlight. And I was discussing one of the webinar, and one of the doctors was telling 11 o'clock to 2 o'clock sunlight is the best thing. And we are all in our offices and our work, 11 to 2 o'clock, I don't think any one of us are privileged. We don't have that kind of thing to sit in the sunlight at that particular time. So I keep trying my best to at least do on Sundays, but I want you people also to look into that. This study was in 2014 a study showed high death rate among sun avoiders was double than that of people who with having sun exposure. So coming to the same thing which we talk about, we're talking about smokers reporting highest sun exposure were found to have similar risk of developing heart disease and non-cancer as non-smokers. So the thing is here, sunlight is giving them the protection. The increased risk of the heart problems and cancer aren't the only potential problems caused by lack of sun exposure. I can always enumerate something like diabetes, autism, Alzheimer's disease, age-related macular degeneration, some specific cancers, or something like multiple sclerosis. All these things are related to the lack of sun exposure. So there are some studies which showed hazardous ingredients in sunscreen, such as oxybenzone, which can cause infertility, birth defects, and hormone disruption in children. And this is what we are trying to tell across, is don't use the sunscreen. And if you are able to naturally get the sunlight, even if you tan, it's not a big issue. Well, tanning can be sorted out. And I have seen people who has good tanning, the sun tanners we call it, they have good, they don't get into this kind of disease and all that. So this particularly, there are some perpetual sun worshippers, but for people who are just going their daily activities, moving the cars and all, they don't know what is the kind of thing. I would like to talk about something called sun gazing here. Sun gazing is something like trying to keep your eyes open, try to keep both your hands in this position and keep it below the navel, that is the solar plexus, we call navel region. And you can just watch the sun directly for whatever 20 seconds, 30 seconds, and you can always take up to a few, if you are good, you can always take up to a few minutes. You can do whenever you can always, because this sun gazing will help you immensely. There is, see this kind of benefits with a lot of people who had get the practice of doing sun gazing. And this is what helps in a big way. So the other things which we are trying to work it out is we have to emphasis on this moderate but consistent amounts of the sun. Don't want to overdo. We are living in a country like India, and we are not into Australia or some other thing where there is a kind of sun exposure can cause basal cell carcinoma. So there you require sun tanning and all that, not at this part of the world. Tell sunlight and all that, synonymous thing which comes is the vitamin D. I wonder why this thing is given the name of vitamin, because it has got there are this vitamins. Now other vitamins are derived from the foods you eat, But what you know that vitamin D comes from the sun. You are on the right. So this is often misunderstood. Vitamin is not vitamin. It's a pro hormone. Pro hormones are substances that converts a hormone, that converts to a hormone. In fact, unlike other vitamins, only 10% of the vitamin D in the body needs comes from the food, and the rest of the body makes for itself. So what is required for your vitamin D? You require a good cholesterol, you require exposure of sunlight and normal cholesterol. That will take care of your 90% of this ones. Yes, we are finding a lot of things these days. Vitamin D resistance is happening with a lot of people. People having autoimmune problems and all that. But I can always tell you one thing. You need to work out at the calcium, magnesium, heavy metal toxicities and all that. Or something like glyphosate, which I have been talking for a long time now. Because this glyphosate, this lead toxicity, they are responsible for the dwindling vitamin D levels in the blood. Even though you are having a sunlight exposure and all that, your body levels of vitamin D are all time low. I am talking about this vitamin D and this present thing as, and everyone knows what is the value of vitamin D in the present pandemic, and to keep yourself healthy, you need to have this vitamin, which is, it is the, it's not just the vitamin, it is a pro hormone. Your body makes vitamin D in chemical reaction when sunlight hits your skin. It works by binding to a protein called vitamin D receptor, which is present in nearly every cell and affects many different body processes. It helps your body absorb calcium, which in turn enables your bones to gain strength by mineralizing them. So research indicates that the best way to raise your vitamin D level is not through supplementation, but through sun exposure. It is crucial for the public to understand that the latest science shows that the real risk is avoiding the sun. So what we have been telling is that, okay, you have to see that your vitamin D levels immediately improves, so that we need to work it out on things also. But along with that, if you are able to have a sun exposure, that will be like, it will be a combination, will be a good strategy to work it out somewhere, because the kind of vitamin D levels what we are seeing these days, less than 10 is a very common thing even among doctors and all. So we believe we need to supplement the 60,000 units immediately and try to work it out. So what is this vitamin D deficiency? How you are picking up? There are simple signs of vitamin C deficiency. The people present with constant aches and pains, which are frequently misdiagnosed. They go run from pillar to post, they go to physiotherapy. Another manifestation is a frequent illnesses and infections due to low immune system. The third one is neurological symptoms from headaches to cognitive impairment happens. And the fourth one is they have fatigue, excessive daytime sleeping, and low back pain. It's a common thing with a lot of people. And you can see a person having a sweaty head, always suddenly gets into sweats with no kind of reason. I ask him to tell, get this, his face, there is sweating. This particular person has often seen in infants also, but can occur at any age. It is due to the vitamin D deficiency. This particular thing has to be worked out, and we somewhere want to tell you that yes, this has to be followed. These are a few of the signs, and you don't have to wait for the signs to appear. Even if you are working, we can check now that the thing is, whatever blood chemistries and all that are, we are easily picking up on the blood levels and all that. But still, these are the few signs, and would like you to look into that and later take up this particular thing, which is sun tanning and sun gazing. Thank you.